Well, it just keep getting worse and worse and worse. I know you said, but Bongs, what do you mean? Well, Sunday Times have reported the following. They say Floyd felt disrespected by Julius Malema behind Malema and Shivambu divorce. Now, here is something. Listen to this one. EFF Insider says Julius Malema was secretly trying to get a deputy president post for himself in the GNU, hanging Shivambu out there, out to dry in the process. Hey, I'm not going to kanjani. Because, you know, he's a member of caucus, you know, he's into this caucus thing. So why is he, I'm talking about EFF and Julius Malema himself. Also, why is he involved in, why is in pursuit of position? You know what I'm saying? That did not land well, doesn't sit well with me as well. I don't know, right? The thing is that I must also warn that right now, you see, the problem with the so-called sources, sometimes these sources are not reliable. So I want to believe them, but at the same time, I kind of feel like, I wish somebody were to confirm something here. Maybe Malema Shivambu confirm something. Then I would be like, oh, okay, it means they were telling the truth. So I will go through the revelation that were brought today. Some things. Yar. Koningo magabani kamcheng seni eti go to moon to. Umuntu yas umuntu lo umuntu incwadi engafundeki ungabo umthembu umuntu ngcono uthembitshe sayikhumbula leyo ngoma. Okay, have you forgotten about that song? Kodwa nje the essence of the song is that you cannot trust a human being because people are unconfirmed. You can't confirm human being. You cannot say you know them. That is the greatest mistake you can ever do. You cannot say I know this person. He won't do that. Also, so I do the tag. You know what I'm saying? Once when you say, but he won't do that, I do the tag for that. So that is probably a dilemma. I'm going to take you through. I'm going to walk you through every single thing that you are here for. But before we can do so, wait a minute. This is what you need to do. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so Sunday Times says EFF Julius Malema and his now former deputy Floyd Shivambu clash over crashy positions in the government of national unity, leading to a dramatic falling out and at the end of their long-standing political relationship this week. Now listen, they say a well-placed source in the EFF, the ANC and the MK party told Sunday Times Shivambu's resentment began building when he discovered Malema had
has cramped the EFF prospect of joining the GNU, in which he could have served as deputy finance minister. Oh, the reason I'm saying, I get it, you know what I'm saying, investigative journalism, I get it. But there's a story that was reported not long ago. In the story, it turns out that the story was not true. So that's why I'm saying, I get what is happening. I get the hype. I get the excitement. I get everything, except one thing. I so wish somebody can confirm this for me. You know what I'm saying? We have seen it. I've got a channel, a football channel. We have seen it in that channel that, there are sources sometimes that are very unreliable. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Listen to this one. The bust up between the two had dealt a feather blow to the EFF, which did badly in the May elections and has brought an upright end to the most notable political bounces in South African politics. While Malema will get a new deputy when EFF holds its elective conference in December, Shivambo is being tipped to be the future president of Jacob Zuma MK party. Sources disclose Shivambo was also aggrieved when he discovered that, unknown to him, Malema had made direct contact with President Cyril Ramaphosa to demand the position of second deputy president for himself and the deputy speakership of another party member. While Shivambo was still in separate talks with the ANC negotiators over a role for an EFF in the GNU. That is what Sunday Times guys they are reporting. Guti, yay, go big EFF. I'm not against investigative journalism because that would have been, this is none other than investigative journalism. So I'm not against investigative journalism. I'm just saying, Guti, there was a story not long. I've forgotten the story. There was a story, we were told everything, but it turns out the story wasn't true. So also. I've read so many untrue stories, right? But this one is based on, you know, when it comes to the Shivambo and Malema story, I don't wanna lie. For me, it feels like, I wouldn't say a dream. Yeah, I wouldn't say a dream, but it feels like a lone move, if I may say. To Umkhonto weSizwe. But then there's another thing that is also before I can go to the other thing, the reason I'm saying that is because this relationship between MK party and EFF. So that's why it is very difficult for a person like me to believe this as mainly, oh, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if I should believe it that way. But another thing that is also spoken of here is that he is tipped to be the future president of MK party. Did you just hear that? Yes, I said it. He is tipped to be the future of MK party. Oh, okay. In terms of experience, Shivambo, you know what, thinking of Shivambo, he's not a person that I can have a problem if he was to be a future president. Shivambo's got a way of addressing things. Let's just take Ama tribes and everything, put it aside. Let's forget about which tribe is he coming from. Forget about that thing, right? Just put it there. Look at Shivambo's credibility and everything. The man fits all the criteria. He the way he speaks, when Shivambo speaks, you wanna listen. Sonje, for me, I feel like if he was to be a future president, if he's a future president of Umkhonto weSizwe, that man is experienced, man. He's experienced. So I will not have a problem with him. You know, I don't care whether it's a Tsonga, Venda, from Limpopo. Is from, I don't care what I'm saying. I don't care. What I care about is, does the man has enough experience? Does the man carries the credibility and all the stuff. So as long as the man meets the criteria, I don't want you to look at your umkonto, make look. Because the reason I'm mentioning the tribe thing is because other people make umkonto wesizwe as if it's look at something that belongs to the Zulus. You understand? Yeah. Umkonto wesizwe is a party that contests elections nationally. So if you are contesting things nationally, you are not contesting elections in KZN, and then you are a national party, you should be able to attract people from all different walks of life. And when you look at them, you shouldn't even look at the color of their skin. You should look at what are they offering on the table. Is Shivambo going to offer EMK party something? I think he is. You know what I'm saying? You understand what I'm saying? I saw white people in Cape Town protesting on behalf of MK Party, members of MK Party. You know, that's what I'm saying. If you are building a political party, a future one, for instance, for that matter, sorry, you need to look beyond tribe. You need to look beyond color of a skin, right? And that, look, also, this thing, it says that... when you speak of racism, you should not think that every white person is racist. You know what I'm saying? I know I'm digressing, but I'm just saying, you should not think that every white person is racist. I'll give an example. I had a lunch with one of white person in my apartment. That person is also my agent. You know, so what I'm saying is the reason why I got this apartment. Because she's a... that woman, she's white, she's African, but free. You know what I'm saying? Free spirit. You know, you don't. When you're talking to that woman, you don't feel racism. You feel like she's just treating you like everybody else, and that's what we're looking for. We're looking for a white person and a black person that can treat everybody like everybody else. As long as people meet such criteria, then we should be good. We can't always be concerned about the color of your skin, even when it is irrelevant. We're looking at the color of your skin. Come on, man. Hey, man. Come on. So, yeah, when you are building a political party or an organization, people must qualify based on ethics, based on good morals, based on whatever is needed after that, whether the qualification or whatever. But once people meet that criteria, then we're good. We're good. We should be good. We should be good. No question asked. Should be good. You know what I'm saying? So, give Shivambo. As long as, for me, he meets the criteria. So, why not give Shivambo? You know what I'm saying? Give Shivambo, if he's going to be the future president. But Sunday World as well reported the following. The revelation cast new light on the joking for the position in the GNU. In spite of Malema having previously roundly criticized the new government as the product of white monopoly, the mixed messages from EFF led to a deadlock between the ANC and the eventual collapse of their negotiations. Shivambo was also the party's chief whip, felt Malema had betrayed and disrespected him as he had been leading the party's negotiation team during the GNU talk. This thing, it's very big, guys. It's very big. It continues to say, what happened is that Floyd felt undermined and disrespected by Julius Malema because he was negotiating with the ANC on one side. Julius Malema was busy undercutting him by going directly to the ANC president, say the insider. This is what made Floyd blew his top and say, but if as the head of negotiations, I'm agreeing with the ANC that I will look that. Wait. Just load something here, guys. Sorry, Ganana. Just give me a moment. I will be accommodated as deputy finance minister. Why are you going and running parallel negotiations? Let me remind you, if this can be proven as the truth, if this were to be proven as the truth, I think, Malema said that he was giving them Floyd as a deputy minister of finance or as a minister of finance. So if Malema then, the very same Malema was also contesting the very same position, it just doesn't make sense. In fact, it means that their relationship was a time ticking bomb because it was just the matter of time before it just blew out of proportion and it became what it now is. But it just says that it was just a matter of time. But yeah, I'm not going to go read everything. The article is that long. But yeah, let me just stop there. You can look at the article. It's called, the heading of the article says, Floyd felt disrespected by Julius behind Malema dash Shivambu divorce drama by is Sunday Times. And then you should be able to get the article. Tell me what you think in the comment section below.